Representative, come on up. Gosh, you know, they give me these bios all the time, and I have, but this is the best one ever from John Lebouttier. He leads Skyhook 2, devoted to bringing home live POWs still held in Southeast Asia against their will, and he's co-host of Political Insiders on Fox News Channel tonight at 7:30. Representative Lebouttier. Thank you, Mike. I'm just going to take a few minutes. It is 5 minutes of two here in Washington, D.C., which means it's 5 minutes of two Monday morning on the Vietnamese border in a series of prisoner of war camps where there are today around 250 still held against their will. I've been over there many times, including three times last year. If you go there, it's very clear that there are these prisoners being held in these camps. In fact, everybody in the vicinity talks about it all the time. They all know about it. Oh yeah, my uncle drives a truck that delivers vegetables to the camp every Monday. It's well known. But the problem for this issue, two things, betrayal and lies. And they come from where we are standing. From this city is the reason the prisoners have not come home. So let me just tell you very quickly what happened. 40 years ago, when the war was coming to an end, we promised to pay Vietnam $4.75 billion, with a B, dollars. And that was done by President Nixon to the Vietnamese, and they promised to give back the POWs. And the first shipment of prisoners who came home included John McCain and others, and they sent about half the prisoners. They had 1,200. They sent 600 home. The famous ones, McCain, Jerry Denton, Richard Stratton, Admiral Stockdale. But they kept 600 back as an insurance policy to get the money. Well, guess what? 43 years later, we still have never paid one penny to the Vietnamese. And guess what? They've never given one of those 600 prisoners back. That is terrible. But the worst part are the people in our government, obviously already referred to members of Congress, but it's presidents of the United States of both parties, congressmen, senators, but the real bastards are the bureaucrats in the CIA, the DIA, the NSA, who have lied to the families of these men. There are a few families here today. And Jerry Kiley and I are very good friends with Carol Herdlicker, whose husband was shot down 51 years ago, 1965, in Laos, photographed on the ground in captivity. 2 years later, recorded a radio interview on Moscow radio by the communists. He was alive. He may still very well be alive at 84 years old. What does our government do about these men? Nothing. And they have betrayed them, and they have lied to the families. They have not shown them the truth about the incidents where their sons or husbands or fathers were lost. This is the most disgraceful cover-up in American political history. The media pays no attention to it. Big surprise. The politicians pay lip service to it. Big surprise. It's the few of us who are left who still care about this thing. So what can you do? A couple things. Number one, it doesn't ever hurt to pray that these men, while they still have a life ahead of them and a breath in their body, can come home and be back in this great country. That would be the first thing. Pray for them. Number two comes this election. Does this election matter for bringing home the POWs that are still there? We have, yes, it does. It always does. So the choice, Hillary or Trump?
Hillary Clinton
was the co-president with her husband for 8 years, during which time they not only did nothing about the POWs, they took that awful, wretched, corrupt Senate Select Committee report and used it to justify normalizing relations with Vietnam, giving away any leverage we ever had. That didn't work. 8 years of Clinton did nothing to bring the prisoners home, and 4 years of Hillary as Secretary of State did nothing. She didn't do squat to bring the prisoners home. So, thumbs down on Hillary.
Yes, that right. You got that right.
Now we get to Donald Trump. Now, Donald Trump got a little twisted up last summer in his anger about John McCain. And I have to speak about John McCain. I've known John McCain for 40 years. There has never been a public official who's been worse on the POW issue than John McCain. Because as a former POW, he has the stature to have put this issue front and center, spoken out, and he could have single-handedly brought these men back. He did just the opposite. He and John Kerry did more to kill this issue than any other elected officials in this country. And last summer, when Donald Trump started running, and he was asked about
McCain,
go
into tent, sir.
And he made a comment against McCain, which was totally justified. He got a little twisted up when he said, my heroes are those who were captured.
Okay.
Later, he did say, oh no, the POWs are heroes. Okay. But let us be very clear about something. We're here today only for one reason. Not the VA, which is bad, or the waiting times for veterans, not PTSD, the suicide rate, Agent Orange, all very valuable and important topics. Today, this rolling thunder, as all 29 years of it, have been dedicated to one thing, the living POWs that are still there. That we commune with them to finally bring them home. So we're going to get a new commander-in-chief. If it's Hillary, the prisoners won't be coming home because of her. If Donald Trump wins this election, I have an agenda for Donald Trump. Number one, got to acknowledge what we've said. The prisoners are our greatest heroes. They're still there. They're still fighting. Their families are fighting and suffering like crazy over them, but not knowing what happened to their guy. It's the worst of all. Not knowing is worse than knowing he is dead. And this is not right. It's a sin on America. So, we've got to acknowledge that the greatest hero is number one. Number two, what did Donald Trump on The Apprentice say every episode?
You're fired!
He's going to have to come in here as president and say, you're fired, to every one of those bureaucrats in the NSA, the DOJ. And they lie right to your face. They lie right to a mother's face, a wife's face, a daughter's face. I want every one of these bastards fired out of this government. And then the final part of the agenda is a new team needs to be brought into this government with a mission. One mission. It is not bodies, crash sites, none of that stuff. That's important. But the only thing that we should focus on right away, do whatever it takes, pay the money, make a deal, negotiate. We want all the living prisoners brought home tomorrow. I'm going to end by saying, I hope that this does come about because of our next president, but I have great hesitation to believe that our government, no matter who runs it, will ever solve this problem. I think the problem is going to be solved. I think it's going to come privately. I think that God wants prisoners to come home, not just for their sake, But this country needs to learn a lesson, and it needs to be so devastatingly horrible that we end up basically taking the whole government that we're surrounded by here today and throwing it all out. And if that happens, the suffering of 250 men for 45 years might have been worth it. Thank you.
Yeah, okay. Thank you.
Thank you very much.